So here we are with lesson two of our new improved Hangman. Last lesson you would have put all the files that we need and got everything set up and ready to go for our changing or adjusting and improving of this program. So in this lesson we're going to refactor our data store module, so it actually is driven by the database rather than our current text file. Now it's important in the refactoring that we need to maintain the current functionality of the data store. So for example, the data store stays as data store as the name of the class, and that the get word method of that data store doesn't change, that we have the same method name, that we have no additional arguments, and that we have nothing differently being returned, it's returning a string. Okay, so we're going to go ahead with that and we need to change that. So let's have a look. We talk about change to a database. So what are we going to change to? So it's a couple of things. This is our database here. You can see that we have a few different tables. We have categories and we have definitions and we have games, and this is all built out so we can create the entire thing. And words is the one that's really important for this particular lesson and this tutorial. If we go to browse data, if I go to words, you can see that we've got 33,753 words. So it's a lot more than what we used to have. So I'm going to come down here and put that down there. But how are they structured? So this is our relational schema of the actual database. You can see each of these represents a table. So we have a user table, a game table, a definitions table, a words table, a category table, and the word table here. And the words category. So this is the one we're going to be working with, but you can see how the primary key is connecting with all the foreign keys. Now again, we're assuming that you have an understanding of SQL. I'm not going to go into any of the SQL in here. This is just about how we deal with the SQL and incorporate it into Python, into our Python program. So that gives you an idea of the actual database. So what are we going to do? Well, before we start each session now, because it's getting a little bit more complicated, at the start, I'm going to talk about how our MVC, so our module, our viewer, and our controller interact. So here we are. We have our view, which is our UI_hangman.py file. We have our hangman.py file, which is our controller, and we have our datastore.py, which is our model. So how do all these interact in the actual game? Well, it's really simple as this, is that this one's really simple, that Hangman is going to send a message to datastore, and it's just basically going to say, I need to get the word. And then the datastore is going to return a single word of three letters or more back to the controller. So let's look at coding this up. So first off, we're going to create a data store method, which allows for us to testing. So we're going to create all the methods in relation to the data store. That way we can test it using our test.py, who I'll just open up there, data store open, and test.py open, and Hangman. So all of our files opened up here. Right, so our data store, effectively what we want to do is that, well, one big thing we need to change, that we need to, because we're using SQL, we need to import from the Python library, the SQL, or from the standard library, I need to import SQLite 3, which is the Python library which deals with SQLite. Now, SQLite is a type of database, as I said in the last video, which lives on your actual computer, so that's the one we're going to be using. So that is the method we're going to, or the library we're going to use to actually deal with this. Now we're going to add, I need to get rid of this. Oh, actually I'm going to add a doc string to our data store at the top up here, explain what the actual data store is about. So our doc strings are always a triple quotation marks followed and then actually putting in what is. This is a class that represents the database of the Hangman game. Rightio, just go fix that database up there. Rightio, so I've got my doc string for the entire actual module. Now, what do we need to do? Well, we need to change a few things. I need to make a new constructor, because our old constructor used to connect up to a word file, which is just up here, a little text file, which is words, or dictionary.txt, right? Used to connect up to it. We don't want it to do that. We want to connect instead to how we how we connect to it. We want to connect instead to our SQL database. Now, this has been fine before, but now we need to change it. So how are we going to change it? We need to understand how Python connects to SQL. So for example, if I was to start Word, which is an analogy, if I start Word up and running, and you would see with Word starts up, I open up Word, and once I open it up, I then have a cursor, which is where I use to type, right? So it's the same kind of thing with the database, is that we actually will connect to our SQL database, which is here, we'll connect to it, but that's one thing. We need to make the connection, we need to open it up, and then we need to make a cursor that we use to actually edit and write with it. So let's start off by changing our data store. Rightio, and we're simply going to say that it connects to the database. So this is changing our init file, our constructor for our database, our new data store. And then I need to, it's just easier if we name our DB file and give it a name. And this one is hangman underscore data store dot DB. It's in the same directory. You can see here it's in the same directory as my data store file, so I don't have to put any other paths in there. That's been named. Now I need to connect to it. So to do that, I say self dot SQLite connection. I'm actually making my connection file, and it's going SQLite 3 dot connect to what I'm connecting to. I'm connecting to the DB file. So that's how I'm making a connection for this instance. Remember, that's what self means. This instance of data store. So when I create a data store, it's this particular instance is being connected, and that connection is saved in the self.connection variable. So now I've got the connection, I have to now make the cursor. So we go self.cursor, and that is going to be SQLite 3 dot connection. No, sorry, I'm bad. It's going to be self.connection. So it's using this connection, and I'm making a cursor on it, dot cursor, open and close. So self, so I've got the connection I've made, and then for the connection, I want to make a cursor, and I'm going to store that in self.cursor. So from now on, when we try to access the database and run things on the database, we're going to be using self.cursor to actually run that. Rightio, so that's the first thing we need to do. The second thing, we're going to do a little new type of method here. It's called a destructor. Now, when working with SQLite and Python, it's important that you close it when you're finished. If, for example, you're writing information to the database, it might be stored in cache, and in closing it will ensure that everything that's stored up in cache or stored up in memory gets written down to the hard drive. So to do that, we make a new one, a new method called this, which is a destructor method. And just like init is automatically run whenever a data store is created, when this data store finishes up, then del, the last thing that happens is that undunder del actually will run, and it will do this. And what's it going to do? Well, let's say what it's going to do. It's going to close the database connection. Rightio, so it closes the database connection. I shouldn't say del, I should say def. I was wondering why those underscores are there. Defining the del method, right? The destructor. So I'm going to say self dot, and now we're closing the connection because that's what we're using to connect to the actual database, and I just want to close it. Right, so now We've created the database, a connection to the database. We have a curse that we can actually make calls to and actually work with the database. And when it actually finishes up, it closes that database, the connection up, and saves all the information. Now, get word self, this is going to do the same. It's going to return a random word of three or more characters from the database. So that's okay. I'm going to get rid of that. I'm going to change this, right? So get word returns a random word of three more characters to the database. So that's our doc string. That's what it's actually going to do. Now I'm going to add a little bit of additional documentation into here. I'm going to start using what Python calls type hints. And so these are the things when you start writing, if I start typing something out like SQLite 3 dot connect, and I put this here, you see this stuff that comes up and it says timeouts afloat and detect is a type of integer and all that kind of information, and it returns none. All of that information is little type information, and we're going to create it so on our own module so that it actually appears, and we use type hints to do this. Now get word doesn't actually receive any information. Don't have to worry about that. But what it does do is actually returns a string. So to say return a string, after the closed parenthesis and before the semicolons, we put an arrow and say string. So that will tell us that it's going to be returning the string. And that'll be, you'll see later on when we type this in, it actually will pop up and tell us, yes, it's going to return a string. So it just makes it easier to follow the information. Now we don't need any of this stuff here. And I am first going to say I need to get the word list. Right. Get word list. So in SQL, in Python, you have some basic commands, but basically what we're doing a query, an SQL query. So whenever you do an SQL query in Python, you need to have a certain number of steps, two steps for the actual SQL command. The first one is you need to execute the actual SQL command itself. So if I say self dot, we use the cursor to execute, and we're gonna say execute, right. Now this is how I lay it out to make it easier for me to read. When I've got the double parentheses there, I go enter to bring it down to the next line. I then add in a multi-line string. So in here, I can write my SQL command like I normally would write it in any other, like in DB browser or any other kind of SQL or database management system. So I'm just gonna say select word from words. Now, is that correct? Let's have a look. You just check the database itself. Still here. I'm going to select word from words. No, it's wrong. I need to have a capital W there. Rightio. Select word. So it is the word column. Oh, wait. Sorry. See it down here. So it's the word field from the table words. Had to be a capital W. So select word from words. That's going to do it. So I'm running an SQL command. Fine, that's no worries. It's going to return to me a whole list of things, right? So once you in Python with SQLite, once you have actually executed your command, you then need to fetch the results. So that's the next stage. So I'm going to say get word list. Okay, I already get word list. So I'm going to get results. Sorry. So to do that, I say self dot, because the cursor is holding the results from what it actually run. I'm going to say self dot cursor dot fetch all. So get all the results, and then I also need to store that somewhere. So I'm going to store that in the results variable. Okay. So I've got my get word. It's going to return a random word of three or more characters. I have got my SQL command. I've put in there. I'm getting the results. Now what I like to do and what we're going to do throughout this video is once we get the results, I'm going to return the results just as is. So I can then actually run a test. So I'm going to run a test over here, and I'm going to change this to get word. So get word, open. Hey, look, see, it tells me it's going to return a string. That's what we did. We did that thing with a type hint, right? So I'm going to say get word. I'm going to print it so I can just see what it actually returns for me. So let's run it, print, and you'll see down here. Well, wait a second. It's returning. It's returning a few things. What's it returning? Well, first off, it's returning, until by the square brackets, return a list, right? And in that list is all different elements of these things around here. These are, what are they? They're parentheses, and therefore it means it's a tuple. The tuple is a collection in Python, much like a list. The only difference between a list and a tuple is that tuples, you can't change it. You can't change the value. A list, you can pull values in, you can push values out, you can change actual values in there. You can't do that with a tuple. So, we're running it, and it's going to show us that we're turning a whole lot of words. But we don't want one word. We only want to actually have we don't have a whole lot of words. We want to have one word instead of a list. So how do we do that? So previously we're using get random before to actually do that. So let's just change this. So instead of saying return all the results, how about instead we choose a random choice, which it automatically always chooses one element out of a list, and the list we have is results, and that's up here. So return random choice, and let's save that and now run that in tests and see what's coming back. And here we are, I have got my one element, but that one element is the tuple I was saying before. So that one element, having a tuple, I want to get the first element of that tuple, not the whole thing. So just like a list, if I want to refer to the first element, I can simply say, because this is returning the entire tuple, so at the end of it, I can just say, yep, give me the first element. All right, I'm going to save that. I'm going to run that and test. And there we go. Wacko, it's returning one word. That's awesome. That's what we want to do. Great. But it's now no guarantee that the word is going to be three characters or more. So we need to actually have a little test in here. So come back to the data store. We now need to see whether it's actually one word, three letters or more. So what I'm going to do is put a endless loop in here to say while true. Okay, comes down and this is going to be in here. So it'll just keep returning a random one, but I want it to stop on a particular process. So I say, let's say word equals, we've got here. So I'm now storing, so saying while true word equals that. And now I need to test word to see if the length of word is greater than three. And if it's greater than three, then return word. And of course, a return will break out of a loop. Rightio? And if its length of word is greater than three, return word, break out of this actual method, go back to the method which called it. And if it's not, it will just then come up to here and then it will just grab another random word. Come down here, get up here, grab another random word, it comes down. Okay, so let's save that again and let's test it. Yep, and we can keep going and we won't find more a word with less than three letters. So congrats, we've done that. So let's see, before we go any further, I've tested it in my pipe, but now this, because we've made this, despite the fact that get word has a lot more details in it, and despite the fact that in it is actually connecting to a database, because data store, the name of the actual class hasn't changed, and because the name of the method get word hasn't changed, and it still is returning a string, whereas previously it was not returning a string, then what you end up with, it should be working fine with a hangman that we did previously. So exactly the same, I'm gonna press run, see, and yes, my hangman works. I'm gonna go new word, and you see it changes. New word, and it still tells me down the bottom what that new word is. I'm gonna change it so it doesn't do that. But okay, So that is all working. So there we go. We've now changed it across. Our data store is now run off a database, which has replicated exactly what was happening before. So we've refactored the data store. But now because it's got a database and a lot more structure there, we can add a lot more features. And that's what we're going to do in the next lot of videos.